Symbiosis had a dream. And the dream was to establish Symbiosis Institute of Management Studies for the dependents of defense personnel. We established SIMS way back in 1993. And this was not my idea. The idea was of Bala Subramanian, who was a lecturer in SIBM. He came to me and he said, Dr. Mazumdar, why not start some institution for the children of defense personnel?
One day I was sitting in SIBM. I see one PMG Nair, Major PMG Nair sir. He is running up and down. Once upon a time I worked with him. So after seeing him from window, I said, we ran and I called him, sir, IA. What is the problem, sir? Why you come after you come after? For my son admission, I am trying. Then I went to the principal, made a request, and somehow he got admission there. I think that was the trigger. So I said, why not to start? You know, a institute exclusively for defense personnel and their dependent. Ultra reservation. Yes, college mein only Fauji ka admission hai. To maine phir bhi ek proposal diya. Mazumdar sahab ke sath mera jo proximity hai, I used. And he has put that up in the managing committee. In those days, he was not president. So one day, as I said, I requested, sir, we can do. And you know, he is always search for ideas. He jumped on this, okay. If you say that you can find infrastructure, you know, it's you, then from my side only, okay, start. He has not taken any permission from any committee. He took a personal risk start, and it succeeded. As a, that 1 year course was a big success. One idea came, there is Prabhat Road mein amara, 15th lane Prabhat Road mein. School hai, they function up to 2 o'clock. So, sir, why don't I go there? And there was a lot of things were there. We went to municipal commissioner, took permission, and then we moved to 15th lane Prabhat Road. So, morning, what to do with these children? So, I introduced internship, on-the-job training. Morning, 7 o'clock, they should report to the company. Work there up to 1 o'clock. Come back, class will start at 2, will go up to 8:30. So, this is the model which I did.
We used to have company. So, we used to have this campus process in Hotel Raviraj, you know. Okay. We used to take the corporates to this hotel, and then there used to be, we used to have PPT. Sometimes we used to get them also in the campus. Many times it used to happen, there used to be break, you know, during the school time, and the company used to come into campus. So all these small children used to start running from the fourth floor till down. So we are walking, taking the company upstairs. Students are running, pushing here. But it's to be a great fun, you know. So, and corporates also used to like, because they come in an education complex. If you see those wonderful smiling faces, they also used to enjoy that. So that was a positive approach, you know.
Fortunately, I think for me, I have been the only person, I guess, at SIMS in the entire 25 years history who has been as a student also and as a director also, actually. So, who has spent, in fact, the maximum time at SIMS, over 6 to 7 years, actually, here. Already, the draft memorandum of understanding was in place, which helped me to facilitate and helped me to accomplish the role and assignments given to me, actually. In fact, I do hope that I have been able to fulfill the trust bestowed upon me by Dr. Mazumdar, Professor Bala, and the Symbiosis.
One day, Professor Balasubramaniam and 4-5 students of SIMS landed up in my office. They had organized a conference on economic liberalization in Hotel President in Mumbai. They called many industrialists and well-known corporate leaders and requested Mr. Ratan Tata to be the keynote speaker and chief guest. Mr. Ratan Tata had agreed to be the chief guest, but being very shy, declined to being the keynote speaker. Having got themselves into this fix, at the last moment, the students wanted me to take up the role of the keynote speaker. The argument that with my very little economic awareness, I'll not be able to speak in front of the experienced and knowledgeable audience, cut no ice with them. They persisted. Finally, I went to Mumbai for this conference. I sat with Mr. Ratan Tata on the dais and delivered a 4G version of economic liberalization. Then came an unexpected request. Mr. Ratan Tata asked me if he could also say a few words. He spoke extemporaneously over 30 minutes and shared his knowledge and experience over everyone's delight. Every public-private partnership project is not a success. You require vision, sincerity and hard work to make it a success. I'm happy that Dr. Majumdar, Dr. Colonel Balasubramaniam and others of Symbiosis Society and Headquarters Southern Command have been able to shape the SIMS to what it is now, a top-ranking management institute. The credit also goes to the alumni who, despite several hardships, took their studies and internship very seriously and have brought credit to SIMS.
SIMS was held in school building for many years, but then we thought that we should have some independent status for Symbiosis Institute. And in one of the functions, General Moti Dar, who was GOCNC in Pune, he was chief guest. And while the function was going on, he just murmured in my ear, "Dr. Mazumdar, why didn't you elevate the department to the level of institution?" I said, "What are the advantages?" He said that institution will carry a better status outside rather than the department of SIU. So I liked that idea. So in the function itself, I announced that from today onwards, the department will be known as institution.
I was lucky earlier to establish an engineering college, what is now called Army Institute of Technology in Pune. Because it was purely Army Institute and that land had already been made available. So I continued to pressurize the government to give us this land. In view of that, we wrote letters to the ex-prime ministers to put in the pressure with the government. Out of the one of the ex-prime ministers' letter, that is Mr. Chandrasekhar, wrote to the defense minister then, Mr. Fernandez. Mr. Fernandez requested the director, at that time Mr. Madholkar, and me to come and see him. So we went and saw him, and he says that his political guru, Mr. Chandrasekhar, had requested for it and he can't say no to it. And he pursued the case with the Prime Minister, and finally we got this land. The land was available from the defense, but it had to be constructed, and by then Dr. Majumdar had agreed that he had sufficient funds to establish the college and start working on it.
I was very lucky that I joined SIMS when we moved into the new campus. So everything was pick and span, and you know, really with all the sort of equipment and accoutrements you required in a business school. And my wife and me, first we started greening the campus, and then we sort of built up interaction with the local faculties, with the local speakers, with the local trade and industry organizations. I started visiting all over India to get the placements going. When I joined, things were very laid back, you know. You guys used to go with 40% attendance and then think it was their right to sit for exam, all that drama. So it took little time to get that. Once about 30% of the batch couldn't sit for the exam. So there was almost mutiny then, you know. But from next year onwards, everything became, fell into place, you know, like that. So those were the little touch points or milestones, you know. in getting letting the students get the best for themselves.
I had heard a lot about SIMS as one of the top B schools in India, and it was in a way my dream to come to SIMS in whatever capacity. So when I was selected as the director and I came and joined here on 1st of June 2009, my dreams were to a large extent fulfilled. I had already imbibed a top quality management institute where academics, placements and other activities were in full swing, and SIMS was doing exceedingly well in them. The foundations laid by the previous directors, that is Colonel Bala, Ranjit Mudolkar, Brigadier Chakraborty, had made sure that SIMS was known all over India. When I joined, of course, I felt that not only must I continue with the same traditions that had been established, but to take it a notch higher and see that SIMS and SIMS students do even better. So therefore, while the focus was on academics and other activities, I tried to bring in a little more emphasis, I tried to put in a little more emphasis and bring in a culture of research as well as participation in competitions. And for that, to help the students, we set up a research cell. We also started B school competitions like the Barcode and Orion. We started other activities like the 360 degree MUN and TEDx, where students would get exposed to people from all walks of life and gain certain insights into other fields of activities.
I'm glad to know that SIMS is celebrating its Silver Jubilee starting from 8th of February. From a small campus in our school premises to a large residential campus in the city of Pune, SIMS has been doing extremely well over the last 25 years. And I think it all comes from the defense background of students. The corporate world really appreciates the adaptability and flexibility of these students when they perform so well when they pass out and move into the corporate world. I feel SIMS should now move to the next level of providing this kind of education to children of defense background coming from SAARC countries, from our neighboring countries. In years to come, I'm very confident that SIMS will be ranked amongst the top 5 institutions in the country.
Greetings to all of you on the Silver Jubilee of the Symbiosis Institute of Management Studies. This is an institution that has always made the university really proud. As a public-private partnership, it stands out in the country as a unique initiative of institutional social responsibility. When Symbiosis decided to start SIMS for the defense dependents, this was something that we were very excited about. And over the years, SIMS has actually proved that this has been one of our best ideas. My greetings to all the alumni, all the directors, staff, and of course, all the current students. And my best wishes to all of you for all your future dreams. Thank you.